Frankie Muniz finds a ride, and driver Brennan Poole stops by to prepare us for what's sure to be a wild Xfinity Series season. How's it going, y'all? My name is Eric. Welcome to Out of the Groove, a rare Saturday episode of Out of the Groove. But yesterday afternoon, some breaking news. Actor turned racer Frankie Muniz has found a new seat for 2024. You know what? I'll just let the Ford performance driver explain it himself.
I'm excited to announce that I will be attempting to make my NASCAR Xfinity debut next weekend at Daytona International Speedway in the Joey Gase Motorsports number 35 Ford Performance Ford Mustang. I can also announce that I will be doing a part-time schedule in the Xfinity Series as well as many other racing series throughout the year, just to continue honing my craft and getting better and better and better.
Part-time Xfinity for the newly rebranded Joey Gase Motorsports, beginning with Daytona this coming Saturday. Now, according to reports, that team has acquired 25th place owner points from Sam Hunt Racing, so Frankie's odds of qualifying for the race are fairly high. I'm rooting for him. Shoot, I'd love to see what Frankie Muniz can do in the middle of three wide at Daytona. Shoot, last year in the ARCA season opener at Daytona, Frankie finished, I believe, 11th, ran well up inside the top 10 for much of the day. From ARCA to part-time Xfinity in just one season, hey, it's go time for Frankie Muniz. He's 38 years old. If he's as serious about his racing career as he seems to be, he can't waste much time. I think it's good of him to take this opportunity and see where it leads, see what he can do. Especially if Ford Performance is putting anything behind that 35 car, similar to what they're doing with like Haley Deegan at AM Racing. AM Racing, historically, a decent team, nothing too flashy, too special, but with Ford support, they could contend for top fives and top tens this year. I'm not sure if the same can be said about Joey Gase Motorsports, but any support Frankie gets from Ford will surely help. Frankie Muniz finished fourth in ARCA points last year, but you know, it's hard to really judge since there were only, I think, six drivers who attempted every race. And Frankie's car was decent, but he didn't have near the budget that, say, Venturini did. So my expectations are all over the place. If he can just finish races this year, not make a fool of himself, that feels like a success. But maybe I'm selling Frankie Muniz a bit short. I really enjoyed talking to Frankie a few months back on this channel. We had kind of an extended interview and conversation. And what really jumped out to me most, and he said this in other places as well, but Frankie is really serious about this. Like, he understands his actor past famous child star. But like anyone, he's still trying to grow as a person, find that next thing. And he truly believes racing is it.
When I put my helmet on every race, or every practice session, whatever it is, I put that visor down and I leave that pit lane, I've never been more comfortable of where I'm at than in that position. It feels like it's what I'm meant to do. I honestly feel that. I just want me to have success in it, like personally, like for me to feel happy with what I've done. I think if I do that, other people will take me seriously as a driver. But in that same sense, yes, I know my past. I know I was on TV. I know it's hard to forget that. And I'm not asking for anyone to forget that, but I would love if people didn't discredit the effort because I used to be on TV, or like take away from what I'm doing on or off the track because of what my past was.
I don't expect him to be a moving chicane out there by any means. I hope he's competitive, because if so, that will be a very interesting story to follow this season. And the Xfinity Series this year is jam-packed full of interesting stories. In fact, that's a nice segue to today's guest segment. My good buddy, NASCAR Xfinity Series driver, Brennan Poole, joins the show. I am now joined by NASCAR Xfinity Series driver Brennan Poole. Brennan, I appreciate you being on the show. Fans watching at home should know that this coming Saturday at Daytona International Speedway, you can come see Brennan and I live at the NASCAR Experience stage. We'll be out there on Saturday at 2:30 p.m. I've never done a live show like this. I think Brennan's pretty used to talking in front of fans at the racetrack. He's been doing it for years. We'll see how it goes. If you want to be a part of this once in a lifetime Live experience, because I don't know they'll let us do it again, be sure to be there at 2:30 p.m. Daytona. I can't wait. Brennan, thanks for being on. I've got a lot of questions to ask you today. You're in the Xfinity Series with a new team this year. The Xfinity Series is stacked. Man, I haven't looked at the unofficial entry list for Daytona yet, but there's 40 plus entries. There's going to be drivers going home. There's a lot of extra pressure on these teams. How important will qualifying be, not only this coming weekend, but especially the first few weeks of the season?
Yeah, I think it's super important. I think there's a lot of teams and a lot of people that are going to be trying to do everything that they can to make sure that they're in this race. Not only is it our highest paying race, which can make a lot of the smaller teams and teams in the middle kind of make their year financially, but it's just huge for the points. You need to start the year off strong. I think a lot of these races this year are going to be seeing Xfinity cars go home, which we've seen a lot of that the last couple of years. So you just want to get in and get out of Daytona and Atlanta really with just some good solid results, especially for teams and stuff that are like in our situation. We'll see. Daytona, the speedways have always been pretty good racetracks for me, so I know if we get into the race and can stay out of trouble and just try to put ourselves in a position at the end of the race to get a strong result, that we can certainly accomplish that. So I know a lot of our team members and people will probably be pretty nervous as we push that thing out for qualifying.
Absolutely. Well, I see you wearing the 44 hat. I love the new look this season. So you kind of talked a little bit there, but how does this change Alpha Prime Racing's approach? Because you and I've talked off the air. The Xfinity Series is front loaded this year. There's 18 to maybe even 20 cars out there that are, I think, potential playoff or even championship threats. So a team like Alpha Prime that's still newer, kind of middle of the road, I guess, how does this change your approach specifically?
Well, I think we just have to be really smart. We have to get through these first two races without any mistakes, and we have to execute. And we're racing in one of the highest forms of motorsports in the world. So as a pro sports team, you just have to be perfect, and it comes down to everybody, all the guys working on the car, myself, the spotter, all of us, pit crew. I think anything can happen, especially these speedway races. I think for me, I'm going to ride the first couple of stages. I'm not really going to do a whole lot. And then maybe the third stage, you have to go. I mean, the chance of a green flag stop, you got to be up with the field. You got to fight for track position at the end of this race. But when do you go? That's a difficult thing. And we all talk about that every year, every time you go and race a speedway. For me, I'm just going to see the energy of the pack and try to make the best decisions and put myself in a position for something to go our way at the end of the race. I think that's what we can hope for. When I look at the field, me personally, there's 20 teams that are the top teams or cup affiliated teams. And then there's sort of the rest of the field. And there's a couple of really good teams thrown in there too, right after 20th. But when I look at it, I really feel like we're a team that's probably 21st. Can we break into that top 20 and maybe beat some of those cup affiliated teams? I think it's going to be a challenge, but I really think that we can accomplish that goal by just no mistakes and putting ourselves in a position to have strong runs. I think everything's positive. I think we all feel good about the year, and really we're just ready to go race.
Yeah. Talking about Daytona, timing is everything. When do you go? When do you make that move, try to charge to the front of the pack? We're talking all about the Xfinity Series, how competitive it is. Why do you think right now the Xfinity Series seems to be growing or getting more competitive?
Yeah, I think that's a really good question. It's something I often think about, especially a lot of the drivers, we try to find and sell our own sponsorships and do things like that. And really right now it seems like the sport and everything's just headed in a really good direction. And there seems to be more dollars and more sponsors coming into the sport. And you see a lot of drivers and a lot of guys that may have money that's already attached to them through their family or whatever, but they're able to sell other sponsorship money. And it's putting a lot more competitive cars on the track with a lot more teams with leased engine deals and more teams affiliated with cup teams, and so it's creating an incredibly competitive field. I mean, when you look at the budgets for a lot of the teams this year, I mean, pretty much the majority of the field have really strong budgets, and they all have good cars and good engines and good pit crews and good information. They're getting sim time and all that kind of stuff, so it makes the field, the Xfinity field, is probably the most competitive it's been in an incredibly long time. I'm personally excited to see about the new TV deal for the Xfinity Series going to CW.
It's a good point.
Everybody gets it. In our country. So I think that's going to bump viewerships. I think that's going to create more sponsorship opportunities. I think, you know, it creates a lot of opportunity for the CW too, to maybe create some cool content and do some more things with some of the drivers. So I'm really interested to see what happens. But I think right now as a whole, the sport's just becoming more popular again. There's a lot more interest in it. And I think people are having fun and enjoying it right now. And so the sport's just kind of in an uptick.
With the CW next year, you know, kind of they're dipping into sports really for the first time. So the Xfinity series will be one of their sort of premier, you know, programs sort of spearheading that effort. So you're right. The added promotion, they're going to want to get eyeballs on their new sports package, and the Xfinity series will be at the top of that. That's a great point. And I, you know, talking about the competitiveness of the Xfinity series, I remember just a couple of years ago when, you know, these independent guys like Jeremy Clements and Jeremy Clements Racing were making the playoffs, were, you know, top 10, top 15 on a weekly basis. That is getting harder and harder for guys like him to crack those marks more often than not. There's a lot of different drivers in different places in the Xfinity series this year. Brennan, I'm sure you studied up on your competition a bit going into this season. The one name I'm very interested to watch this year, though, is Shane Van Gisbergen, driving for colleague technically, although the car kind of looks like a track house car. What's a successful season, do you think, for Shane Van Gisbergen? You know, he's a guy, he's about your age, he's raced for a long time, but he's so new to stock cars. Like, how do you expect him to transition to ovals? How challenging will that be for someone like him?
I mean, I think the ovals will be incredibly challenging. I think we're all going to see just how talented he really is. And see how quickly he adapts to the oval. But there's going to be a lot of things that he's feeling for the very first time that he's never felt before, you know, which sometimes, you know, can throw you for a loop for a little while. You got to feel how these cars react in the air when someone's side by side with you, or when you're behind someone, or when someone packs air in your left rear quarter. He doesn't know. He hasn't felt any of that. You know, he ran that truck race at ORP, or
I think IRP, it's
IRP now. So, you know, I you don't feel, there's not, you know, it's like a real short track type style race. You don't feel a lot of the air. You don't, you know, it's a totally different thing. So, you know, I don't know. I'd be curious to see what he has to say after he goes and runs Atlanta and Vegas and some of these other tracks. You know, I obviously think he'll be very strong on the road courses. That's something he's got a lot of experience doing, and you know, he'll be very tough. Probably will win a road course race in the Xfinity series this year, but. But I don't know if you can put like a because I think everyone just has no idea what's going to happen. We race so many ovals, and there's so much stuff that he's never felt before that I don't know, just like progress every single time he races an oval, and hopefully he can, you know, knock himself into the playoffs with a win on a road course. I'm sure that's kind of what they're shooting for.
Before I let you go, Brennan, I got one final question. I was watching NASCAR Full Speed on Netflix, and it focuses on the Cup Series. You made some Cup starts last year. You had a little cameo in there, your line, you know, going after Ross Chastain after Dover made the cut. But I wanted to ask, if you were asked to be on the Netflix show, if they bring this back next year or years to come, how much access would you give that show into your personal life?
Yeah, I think that's a good question. I would definitely just, you know, I'd let them do whatever they wanted. I mean, I want the fans to know who I am and what my life is like. I think, I hope Xfinity or maybe even with CW in the future, since they're their own network, they could do some kind of a spinoff with the Xfinity guys or a few of them and follow them around, which I think would be very fun. I think the fans would enjoy that. You know, I think one thing that was great about the series on Netflix was, you know, Denny really let them in and gave them that access. And, you know, from a lot of people, even, you know, my family members and stuff are like, man, you know, made them like Denny more, right? For where they may not have liked him as much before this point. And so getting to really know somebody a little bit more, I think creates opportunity for more fans. So yeah, I was awesome. I had a cameo in there, and I got to relive that moment again. But that was fun. You know, I got a lot of messages from a lot of friends and people I grew up with that probably don't watch the sport as much, but watch the series. Like, you know, you're in it. I'm like, yes, I know. But
Netflix, you know, star Brennan Poole. There you go.
It was fun. Yeah, I get to be. I'm on Netflix, man. It's pretty neat. So yeah, I think it's cool. I hope that they can do something with Xfinity too, and the other series, maybe the networks will do something cool. CW, please listen to this Out of the Groove show and think about that for the future, because that would be really fun.
I like that idea, the spinoff with the CW. They could make it happen. They absolutely could. That'd be fun to watch. Brennan, I really appreciate you taking some time out of your basically the final week of your off season to come on the show and chat with us a bit. Fans, I'll remind you all once again that this coming Saturday, February 17th, if you're going to be at Daytona International Speedway, it's a busy day of racing. Take a few minutes out of your day to come join the two of us at the NASCAR Experience Stage live. We'll be chatting racing, recording a live episode of our Power Hour podcast. I can't wait to hopefully see a whole bunch of you guys there. I'm sure Brennan feels the same. Brennan, I guess I'll see you in a few days. Really appreciate you being on the show. Good luck this season.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate it. It's going to be a lot of fun. Looking forward to our live show. Also, any 1099 tax filers that are listening to this, go to financeproplus.com/bpool and see how you can get some money back on your taxes. Who doesn't want that? It's better in your pocket. Do it. All right. Thanks, Eric. I'll see you in a week.
Awesome. Yeah, tis the season. Check that out. Thanks, Brennan. One more time, this coming Saturday at 2:30, Brennan Poole and I will be live on the NASCAR Experience Stage just outside Daytona International Speedway gates, you know, in that midway area. We'll be talking racing. We might have an additional guest join us. The plan is to take some fan questions from the crowd, so hope to see you guys out there 1 week from today. Thank you for watching this video. Leave a like, subscribe, and a huge thank you to my very generous Patreon supporters. Have a wonderful Saturday, folks. I will catch you again real soon.